stage magic. And there's different varieties of that. In the group we have, we get the whole kind of spectrum of people doing the different things. A third year member of the junior club is Christopher Cameron. Christopher's 12 years old. Now he's another exponent in karate, and he holds a green belt in Hapkido. He also enjoys baseball and swimming. Christopher's here today to share with you his presentation, Dying Silks. Christopher. Act is Brian Flyhammer, and Brian was involved in magic prior to becoming a junior member. He's 15 years old, and he also plays in organized hockey. So we have athletes, we have people who do a bit of everything, collect coins, get involved in computer operations. Brian's going to come out here and present an interesting trick called Tricky Bottle. So let's give Brian a warm welcome to come out.
Weird things happen, right? So, could you take your bottle and your container, please? I just hold the bottle, palm up. All right, now show everybody that your tube is empty. All right, you see the tubes are empty? That's good. Okay, just put the tube right over the bottle like that. That's good. Now cover the top of the tube, okay? Now you with me. Turn the tube over once, twice, three times. And now your bottle is right side up, as it should be. Okay, you know what? How about we flip the bottle over? We'll try it again, okay? So, you've got it. Hand over the top. Once, twice, three times, and again the bottle is right side up as it should. You know, I have an idea. Why don't we trade bottles? You know, maybe I got the bottles mixed up backstage. Alright, so you take your bottle and you hold that palm up on your hand and cover the bottle with your tube. Okay, that's good. You with me? So you flip the bottle over once, twice, three times, and again your bottle is still. Okay, that's okay. That's okay. And you flip your bottle back over again. So you're pretty good at flipping the bottle over, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's on purpose, right?
Yeah.
Right, okay. So we'll have a race to see who can flip the bottle over, alright?
Yeah.
So one, two, three, go.
Amazing. He starts with Jerry Cole and works up to beer later on. This thing's from Rome, beer that comes out of Mexico. Thank you, Brian. Now, Les Brattlesby, who's been in the magic business for, I don't know how many years to tell, he has been in the magic business for a long time. He started when he was about 9, 10, 11 in that area, and that's a number of years ago. He also helps coach these young people. And he's helped coach these next three people. The first performer is Scott Pearson. Scott's a second-year student, and Scott is 16 years old, and he's a soccer player. He's going to perform the pretty effect, the Chameleon Silks. So, Scott, can you come out here, please?
I didn't want my white silk to be left out, so I blend it on together and got it out.
Even though some of the tricks look the same, different personalities put it across with different villain figure. Our next to last performer is Donovan Deschner. Now, Donovan's been a junior member for 4 years. He's also a golfer. And he loves golf. He's going to display today an interesting rope routine called Two Ends and the Middle. So let's give a warm welcome to Donald.
Thank There are three very important characteristics with a piece of rope. Two ends and a middle. I'll simplify it for you. Two ends and a middle.
Washing line disappears, everything anything connected with rope disappears, and you find it in their little bags that they carry around, the magic. We're down to our final performer for today, and our final performer is Abbas Yamohammed. Bass is 14 years old, and he's a second year member of the Magic, the Junior Magic Group. Now, he's been involved in magic for about 3 years. He also works out in karate and has a black belt in Taekwondo. He also participates in competitive swimming. He's appeared on television, on the A Channel, the Big Breakfast Show, and in this evening, or this afternoon, when he's going to present his magic, it's called Candles, Silks, and Cards. So let's give a warm welcome for Abbas.
Thank you.
evening, folks.
Well done.
For people who really, who this is their first stage appearance in front of the public other than the family, people that are also up there on television, I think we've got a good future here in Magic with the group we have here. Wouldn't you agree?
Yes. Yeah.
The season starts again in September. I wish to address my next few remarks to our young magicians. You're on the threshold of a fascinating medium, an art medium that is outstanding. If you have ambitions to advance as amateur, as semi-professional, or even professional, magicians of this kind can only achieve this only by constant hard work and dedication. The instructions you received this past year have been of the highest quality, as I think everyone has stole witness to today. And I think that if you take this challenge and perfect your skills, especially the basic moves that you have been taught, it will suit. Yeah, I'll join with you as long as you like. Make good all the spare time that you have this summer and practice. You will reap the rewards when in September we start up again another session of Junior Magicians Club as we move into the new millennium. I give an instance of this. Young Ryan Pelling, who is one of our instructors, who's now been 2 years in our senior club from the juniors. Every time I meet this young man, he's always got a deck of cards in his hand. If he's talking to you, no matter what he's doing, he's working the cards. He keeps his hand in, and that's the only way that you can get and be proficient at what you're trying to learn. Today's show came about with the help of members of Big 66. Foremost are the instructors who have devoted many, many hours during this last year. I asked them to join me on stage, at least introducing right off the bat, and I did today. Sorry. there are certain people that I wish to thank, especially today included Brian Taylor, who was our MC, with his terrific job as MC for the day. Everett Andrews, who is in Saskatchewan on doing several performances there in that province, who is performing and who is thank you for his magic supplies. He's helped us in putting all this together, and also being a substitute instructor when called on. Ryan Pelling, who is also absent, is our computer wizard, and he is responsible for our announcement, flyers, the show program, and the certificates that are now going to be presented to the young magicians. I would like to recognize Jared Deschner for his help, and also his cousin for helping us on with the foremost and very important job of putting the tables on, taking them off again. Stagehands. Dick Gray is our video decorator for this day. Instructors, if they will present the graduation certificates for this past season to their students. Next page, you're not known. This Keith here is a new member to our society, and he was responsible for our playback music and so forth to accompany our. tubes come up, and once you receive it, would you just stand to one side, all stage here to one side. David Dewar. David, congratulations. Matthew Stetsko. Matthew. Not here? Oh. Okay. Anyone know? Is he gone? Okay. Tyler Deck. Daniel Shearer.